Hello and welcome. In this video we will learn to create an image map in HTML. This is my image file which I will be using to create an image map. So first we have to use a file. We have to open it in Paint so that we can use the coordinates and see the coordinates here in Paint. So first we'll use this image inside our HTML page. So this is a basic HTML page where I have used an image. For this image we have used a map which is named as flower map. Now you can see here flower map, in that three shapes are given: circle, rectangle and polygon. So the first shape is circle. So you can see here in this image, this flower, I want it in the circle shape for a map. So first we'll get the center. So center value you can see here in the bottom. So whenever you move your cursor over the center of the flower, you can see the coordinates. You have to note down these coordinates and write it down here in this flower file. So this is the first two values, is the coordinate, and the third value is the radius. So here I have specified radius as 300 pixel. This is the alternative value, and this is the link to the next page. Then there is another shape, that is rectangle. So here we have to first plot the first point, that is the first point of the rectangle, and then the next point in the diagonal. So if this is a stem I am referring to as rectangle. So I'll draw and show you. This is the first shape that we are going to use, okay, and this is the second shape that we are going to use. So this is a rectangle. So first we'll take this point, first point value from here, and then the next point value from here and second value from here. Okay, so you can see the first value in the bottom and then second value again here in the bottom. The coordinates, you have to note down these coordinates in this flower file. So these are the coordinates. Then in the same way we have to give an alternative name and then the link to the next page, that is stem.html. The third shape or area that we are selecting is having shape polygon. So polygon will have many coordinates depending on the area that you want to select. So in this image you can see that I am selecting a area of polygon. So this is the area that I am selecting. So you can see while drawing this polygon also I was plotting different points. So you have to consider these points. So xy coordinates for the first point, then xy for second point, third point and similarly fourth point. All this you have to give here inside the flower.html file. So you can see there are total 8 coordinates given because the polygon is having 4 corners, that's why. So the next pod.html is the link. Now I have created individual pages for this pod, then for stem, and then finally for sunflower. Now let's run this and see the output, how it appears. So this is the main file that I am going to use. So you can see here, this is a circle area which is having a link. You can click on it and you are redirected to the page sunflower.html. Similarly, the stem, it is the area that we have used as rectangles. If you click on this, you are redirected to stem. And this is a polygon area. So if you click on this area, you are redirected to pod.html. Thanks for watching this video.